angels under the command of the archangel Michael. Michael and his angels fought with a dragon, and you know who the dragon is. And the dragon and his angels, now here we have the dragon and his angels. And these are the fallen angels, which are the demons today. They fought, the dragon and his angels, the fallen angels, fought against Michael. But they did not prevail. Nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the great dragon was cast out, the serpent of all, called the devil, Satan, may the Lord rebuke him, amen?
Amen.
Who deceives, the deceiver. There was no place found for him in heaven, and he was cast out. How many angels did he took? Well, we have a scripture in verse 3 that says, another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great fiery red dragon, again the dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 diadems on his head. He still drew a third of the stars in heaven and throw them to the earth. So definitely it's not referring to the stars as we know it. So it has to be a symbolic description of the angels. He took one third of the angels, which are the demons today. This is why we have so much demons operating, deceiving. They obey. They were deceived. They obey. They follow him. That's all they know. And then we have the angels. Then we have the spiritual creatures. The fallen angels. And the angels who did not keep their proper domain, but left their own abode. But he has reserved in everlasting chains under darkness for the judgment of the great day. And let me just give you something. The angels who did not keep their proper domain. Matthew. Well, if you were to go to the original, another word that is used there, this is proper domain, is correct. Because domain is something that is yours, that you have, that is given to you. No one else, it's just you. But another word for the proper domain is dignity. They left their dignity, their honor, what was given to them, what God bestowed on them. They did not appreciate it. They went after the enticement of the deceiver for something greater. I'm going to make you guys more powerful than the other angels that serve God. Just follow me, and I'll give you things. And this is how the deceiver came to the Lord. And in a moment's time, he showed him all the kingdoms of the world. And he said, Jesus, you don't have to die. You don't have to go to the cross. You don't have to have your hands pierced, your side pierced, your feet, the crown of thorns. You don't have to go through that. Just worship me, and all these kingdoms I will give to you. The deceiver. Not speaking to you, and I want you to some of you have something that God has given you. You know. You know that you're good for certain things, and it's a gift from God. And God desires that you use what you have for His kingdom. Yeah. I got blessed with Brother Phil this Thursday when he's a very sharp supervisor. And everybody tells them, according to what he was saying, everybody tells them, you're good, you're good. But then the Lord spoke to him and said, you know, the way we do things for your job, do it for me. And he said he started, you know, sobbing, crying. Yeah, I want to do it for you. And there's people that I know that they have such a beautiful voices. They play the piano so beautiful. They sing so beautiful that I know. Close to me. But they had abandoned their place. Their proper domain. Their habitation. And they're not doing what God wants them to do. There's one person that I know, he lives in another county, so gifted with a voice. Gifted, beautiful voice. But he abandoned his habitation. And yesterday, there was a funeral. This lady that is a child, 12 years old, 10, 11 years old, gifted with a beautiful voice and plays in a beautiful church with beautiful people, with beautiful pastor, beautiful environment. This is what I want you. This is what I gave you, the voice. This is your prayer place, your habitation. But then the deceiver comes. The deceiver comes. Hey, you don't have to be in the little church. I got money for you. I got fame for you. What will a man profit if he gains a whole world? And at the end, loses its soul. And how tragic was the event of her death. But God intended for good. The devil turned it around. But there's always a deceiver that comes. And I want you to apply the word. There's something that